Things to put inside my coffin instead of my body. Bones that aren't my own, bones that aren't human, clean, bleached by the angry sun, some sea glass, a button, a bobby pin, a piece of cloth that smells like my mom, loose change, moss, all my squeezed out paint tubes. I assume I'll have painted many things by then, so I would have to have reached the end of a few tubes, right? Crumpled receipts for tax purposes, of course. Holographic Pokemon cards, Nickel City tokens, an interesting leaf, grass from Golden Gate Park. Yes, actual grass, not the other stuff. Okay, maybe a little bit of the other stuff too, but only for comedic effect. An earring, only one, not the pair. A broken necklace, my favorite lipstick. A lock of my husband's hair. Something, anything that smells like my son right after he was born. A pumpkin seed, a feather from a city bird, a keychain, a Caltrain ticket. Zone 2-1 for pleasure, zone 2-2 for business. A syringe. Yeah, we can't get all caught up in the pleasant memories, can we? I had to balance it out. A reminder seemed fitting. Anyway, dead butterflies, a tooth, of course. Candy, partially sucked on and rewrapped. Mannheim steamroller Christmas CD cases. CDs missing. A miscellaneous electrical adapter bit that surely goes to something important, so I don't have the heart to throw it away. A piece of my grandfather. I don't care what it is. Anything he touched is great because he is a great man. A locket. Lip gloss from the 8th grade. A McDonald's Happy Meal toy. No fucking Barbie dolls. A pair of jeans with holes in them, actually worn away by flesh against ground. None of this factory distressed fashion bullshit. A sunflower head, seedless. A metal butterfly clip. Artie the Bear. And I think that's it. Fuck. A coffin is no place for a body. Mm-hmm.